Hey guys, what's going on and welcome back to 7 Days to Die. Currently, we are on day 6. It is almost morning, so time to head out. Before we begin, I'd like to welcome all new subscribers to the channel. If you're new to this channel and you have suggestions for any types of games, feel free to leave a comment down below. Don't worry, I read all comments, so I'm pretty sure I will read yours as well. So for today, I wanted to go explore the wasteland again, and hopefully this time we can find a decent point of interest, either a calipers or something of that nature, because as of so far I've only found small camps or just small cabins in general. I'm hoping to find a large city or settlement where we can hopefully find a bookstore or anything of that nature. So let's get into it. Alright, so let's go to skills because I have a couple of skill points available. I want to level up my blunt weapons because I think melee is really improved in this update, Alpha 13. Also, we are currently on Alpha 13.4. And I'm hoping with these skill points I can create better melee weapons and I can do a little bit more damage, save some arrows from my bow and arrow because, well, unfortunately it is not really good, my bow, and well, feathers are not very common, so hopefully with a melee weapon I will be able to save some ammo. And I'm just going to use all these points in various skills to level them up and see how that will deal us in the long run. Alright, moving on. I'm just going to go in a random direction towards the waypoint. What is that? Looks like a duffel bag. Azalea? It's like a plant or something. Oh, shit. No. That was a little bit too close for comfort. Holy shit. Alright, let's get out of here. We've got a first zombie. Gonna get it. Alright, let's test out the melee weapon. Oh yeah. Satisfying. Another stupid zombie. Get shrecked. I think actually the blunt melee weapons are pretty good actually. They stun the enemy and they do a lot of damage, so that's good. I think we did pretty good by leveling up our blunt weapons. Alright, so I'm back on the road. Still haven't really found anything besides, well, a cabin and a camp. But like I mentioned, I'm really hoping to find a large city where we can stay overnight and loot a couple houses. Because I really need to upgrade my weapons and I need to find a lot of things that I need in the long run. So I guess I will just keep my fingers crossed, keep on moving. Hopefully, eventually it will pay off. I don't know, it's really weird that I haven't found any settlement besides the gas station and the hardware store where I'm staying. So I don't know, it might be just my bad luck though. But I guess we just have to keep a positive mind and keep killing zombies. That's like, I think this game is really satisfying in the way you kill zombies, dismember them, melee them, it's really fun. So I try to kill as many zombies as possible. Plus it gives you experience. We'll be able to level up some more skills. Yeah, the Blunt melee weapons, they are really good now. I should have known this sooner. Oh, also, I am infected, but I'm going to cure this with the jar of honey. Awesome. So jars of honey now function as antibiotics without the gaining of wellness points, but it's a great feature being able to cure infection with honey. All right, well, again, I found a little cabin that I kind of want to check out. You never know what you're going to find there. But yeah, still, like I said, there is nothing like a large city in this vicinity. All right, let's just kill all the zombies here so I have a little bit of a breathing room to loot this little cabin. And hopefully we'll walk away with something valuable. I don't know. Maybe a book that we need for unlocking some stuff. I'm just guessing. I'm just speculating. Who cares? Also, these red plants that I'm collecting, they are the let me kill this guy first. There he goes. The red plants that I'm harvesting are also, I think, the most effective plants to make into tea, but I might be mistaken. But that's what I've found out, so. Right, we are in some water. Nothing. Ooh, food, always good. Coffee beans and some lead. So yeah, I don't know what you guys think of 7 Days to Die, but I'm still enjoying the game very much, even though I played it for almost 500 hours now. But each update that comes out makes the game interesting again. I don't know why, but in my opinion, it's a really fun game. There's a lot of things to do, and we are like only on day 6, so there's a lot of progress to be made still. Okay, I will need to hang on to bullet casings because I cannot make them just yet. And a medicine cabinet that I almost forgot about. And we went up 1 point in wellness. We now have 104 wellness. That is good. All right. Let's continue on our search for whatever, like a city or something point of interest. Better than a small cabin like this, because, well, a couple of cabinets, that's it. So I'm really, really hoping to find a good point of interest so we will be able to get the things we need, because I have a long, long list of things that I will need. And another camp. I really don't need camps. I need to find a big city. That's all I care about at this point. Come on, pick it up. So yeah, all I need right now is to find a big city so I can loot that place. So let's just move on. What is over here? I think I already came from here. Some more food. Always good. Another zombie. It just looks like a house that I've been before. Okay, zombie is dead. Yeah, I need to clear out the zombies to be able to loot this place in quiet. Plus, the daytime is fading fast. We're approaching nighttime again. So it might be a good idea to stay here for the night. Come on, man. Why am I not hitting this stupid zombie? yeah. You dead, son. Nurse, I mean. Alright, any more zombies here? Yeah, there's one. Let's use the melee weapon on this nurse. Don't you swing your hands at me. Okay, so four hits and the zombie is dead with a melee weapon. That's actually not really bad. Could be better, of course, but I guess we need to level up our blunt weapon skills. Okay, so all of a sudden, all the zombies started to come alive, I guess. But hey, the more fun for me. But yeah, so far I haven't really found anything interesting except like a couple of these houses or campsites, whatever you want to call it. Come on, I cannot even aim. I'm so freaking stupid. Oh yeah. Zombie bites the dust. Anything else? Oh yeah, you stupid freaking crawler. They're so difficult to spot in the grass. It's a good thing I heard them. Come on, just die, you stupid ass. There you go. There you go. That's you just had one job, and that's to die, man. And you did it. You did your job. Good zombie. There was another bear over there. Let's not poke the bear. Alright, time to investigate this. Yeah, this is definitely a place I haven't been before, but it does look like a building that I have looted before. Oh, duct tape. I'll need that for weapon repair kits or whatever. Alright, so how am I going to get inside? Some grass. Yeah. Alright, well, let's see if we can find a better suitable entrance. And some more grass that I need. Good. Yeah, this door is definitely weaker than the other one. Alright, we are in. Really? These weapon parts are so weak. I kind of don't want to keep them, but yeah. I'll probably need them later on anyway, so. I'll never use the short barrel, so I'll just scrap it. Alright, give me something good. Ooh, what is that? A puff coat? Swear that. Get a little bit more warm during nighttime. And I'll scrap the tank top. Nothing. Gotta be kidding me. Alright, another bookcase I can check. Again, no freaking books. Are you kidding me? Well, I've got a decent amount of paper, but I really need recipes. Alright, well, enough complaining, let's just continue on looting. Nothing. A little bit of gunpowder. I kinda don't know why I'm hanging on to the gunpowder, but hey. I might be able to craft a bullet. Who knows? Ooh, let's actually close the front door. Because, well, it is approaching nighttime, like I said before. So it might be a smart idea to close the door before the zombies are going to get in here. And I leveled up. Only 8 points to spend? Are you kidding me? I hope that the skill points that you gain when you level up are going to increase each level that you are going to level up. Some more stuff. Ooh. That is nice. I always want blueberry pie, man. Yeah. Oh, and it gave me another point of wellness. That is great. Let's loot this dead survivor. Magnum frame. And a magnum cylinder. Yeah, I really want to hang on to these. Alright, let's move on. Alright, so I am thinking I'm going to stay in here for the night. Because it is now 2100 hours. And we have one in-game hour before the zombies are going to be more strong, faster, and more dangerous. Alright, I'm gonna take off the coat because I'm overheating, apparently. And time to break this open. Oh, what? Those are actually pretty good quality levels. That is a great find. Alright, well, time to be quiet. I'll see you guys in the morning. Hopefully. Alright, I think we're pretty much safe for the night. Good. Yet another night we survived. That is really good. But still, no city found. So what I'm doing is I'm going to go back home, clean up my inventory, and we will continue this in another direction, I guess. So let's get back home. Still pretty dark in the morning. Alright, finally, I made it back home. And it looks like I will have to do some repair jobs. But first, let's drop off our loot for today. A lot of weapon parts, that is just great. Yeah, a lot of weapon parts. Awesome. It's just what I needed. Alright, let's see what kind of damage the garage has. Ooh, that is not good. Okay, so I really want to board this up, just in case that the zombies get in the backside. So, let's make some wooden frames. And let's start repairing this. And also, let's cook up some tea and drop off some resources. Like that. Got some more beans and some food-related items. So I'm going to cook up red tea. Because I think red tea is better than the goldenrod tea now. Apparently, goldenrod tea gives you 20 stamina points. And the red tea gives you 40 stamina points. So that is why I decided to take the red tea. Or not take it, but make it. Alright, that should be fine. Anything else? I guess that is it. Putting some stuff in the forge, like lead. Some more iron that I can put in there. And let's get back to fixing up the garage. I should actually like replace the entire garage, but that is going to be for a later concern. I just want to fill up these holes, make it a little bit more secure, even though it is not really strong, but hey, it's better than nothing. done. Alright, let's check up on how that is going. I could have just taken the frames out of the construction crate. It's pretty stupid. Alright, so I need forged iron to repair my axe. And I'll put in the brass, so I will be able to make bullet casings whenever I found the calipers. Hopefully soon. Which leaves me to the next thing. We'll move out in another direction and hopefully we'll find something, because so far I'm just like running in a random direction, not finding anything. I really hope we can come across a large city. We really need to find a large city. Come here, you fucking chicken. Man, these chickens are so damn hard to hit. Where did they go? Gotta be kidding me, man. Stupid chicken. Stupid asshole. Oh, that's a piggy. Thought it was a chicken, that's pretty stupid. But the chicken led me to a duffel bag. Ooh. Another melee weapon. That was good. Pistol parts I will hang on to. But that melee weapon is actually pretty bad, so I'm just gonna scrap it. Alright, back to our quest for finding a city. Sit down, frickin' zombie. I also found chicken. Give me your feathers. I really couldn't care less about the meat. All I want is your feathers. I know, I'm a cruel bastard. I'm such an asshole. But hey, survival situation, survival of the fittest, gotta make tough decisions, and sometimes be an asshole. I thought I saw something. Is that a rabbit? It's a rabbit, alright. Yeah, fuck it. I am just going to only kill chickens. What the hell is this? What is going on? Wow. That is amazing. Is this like natural landscape or is this random gen messing up its algorithm? I don't know, but it looks awesome. Okay, let's check on the map. I don't know, man. Oh, it looks like a dead end. Oh, just my luck. How am I going to get up there? Another zombie. So this is basically random gen algorithm messing up. There's no other way. But at least we have some resources that we can mine from here. But how am I going to get up there? Okay, so I've been busy for quite a while, as you can see. It is already 4 in the afternoon. And I'm kind of high up here. Plus, the bad thing is, I have a fear of heights. And every time I look down, my stomach, like, starts turning a little bit. So, please do not drop down. That would be insane. Okay, come on. We're almost there. We got this. Oh, yes. Oh yes, we found a settlement, just what we needed. But why did it have to be all the way on top of this stupid frickin' rock? I guess we shouldn't complain. We at least found what we were looking for. So let's investigate this and see if we can find a hardware store, a bookstore, pop and pills, Shamwave Foods, a Shaka Messiah, any one of those five. Is fine. Okay, how far is that? Oh, that's not very far. Okay. Yeah, the only problem is how am I going to get down once I'm up here, like, for real? Ha, zombie down. But yeah, finally we found a city that was what I was looking for, and hopefully we can find the things that we need here. So far it looks pretty quiet. Let's hope it stays that way. Oh, another zombie. Gonna get it. Nice shot. He's still not down. Holy shit. Okay, time to bust your fucking skull, you bitch. There you go. Next time, stay down. Okay, so we're approaching nighttime again. Time goes pretty fast. And I kind of want to kill out the zombies that know I am here, so I can go inside one of these buildings undetected and hopefully survive it. There you go. Stay down in front of a bitch. At least zombies dropped me some loot. That is good. I shouldn't like attract their attention, but I'd rather deal with them now while it is still not nighttime. 'Cause at nighttime, I'm pretty sure we'll have a problem if these guys are lingering around in the city. Ooh, that was nice. Get shrek, zombie. Alright, let's see here. There's nothing there. Ooh, Shamway Foods. Alright. So we found our first store. That is awesome. Stay down, you fuck. There you get Shrek, mate. Damn, where are all these zombies coming from? Fucking leave me alone, you sons of bitches. I think that's pretty much it. No, I'm not hearing any zombie activity, so that's pretty good. Ooh. Some pretty good items. Let's take them. And let's grab that. Another car we can check. Like, I'm gonna survive or try and survive the night in the Shamway Foods. What is that? Another store. Awesome. I can't see. Oh, it's a hardware store. The orange roof is a hardware store. Awesome. More chance of getting better tools. That is insanely good. Headshot. Get wrecked, zombie. Holy hell. Well, if you zombie could be so kind and break the front door for me, that's gonna save me a lot of trouble. And in the meantime, I'll kill off the zombies here. Where the hell did you. Where did these guys come from? Like, for real. Nothing. There's more inbound, I heard. Another stupid zombie. Oh, that was actually a pretty good shot. I'm getting pretty good with the bow and arrow, if I might say so. Oh, you're still not dead, huh? Another store over there. What is that? Goddamn, more zombies inbound. I think that's a poppin' pills from what I can see. Alright, good. Thank you for breaking the front door, ma'am. Now, if you would be so kind and just die, that would be lovely. Oh my god, what the? What? Where are these guys coming from? Is this like a stupid horde or something? Please tell me this is not a horde. I've been like trying to clear out this path or this place for the in-game two in-game hours, and it's fucking ridiculous. Alright, it sounds like they have died, all of them. At least it's a little bit more quiet now. Perfect timing to get in here. Close the front. Block it off. And start investigating this location. Oh yeah. Awesome. With so much to loot here. And I almost don't have any inventory space. You gotta be kidding me. I guess what I'll have to do is I'll have to make a drop-off chest. Ooh. I'm gonna eat that. Probably give me some wellness. Whoa, 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 whoa. Oh shit, it is 10 a.m. Alright guys. Unfortunately, I am all out of time for this episode. Leave thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Thank you all so much for watching. And I will see you in the next one.